Hi, my name is Haley Donna Dale, and I'm a food scientist and chef here at the Center for Culinary Innovation at NAIT. We're here to discuss 5 different techniques to safely handle meat at home. So once you've preheated your oven, you want to get together your seasonings for your meatloaf mixture. Our cutting board here is a non-porous plastic cutting board because it prevents microorganisms from being soaked up by the board. Wooden cutting boards, most of the time they are less food safe than our plastic cutting boards, just because wood tends to be a little more porous and likes to absorb liquids from foods. First, we're gonna chop up this onion. This goes directly into our bowl where we're gonna mix our meatloaf. Once you're done adding your shelf-stable ingredients to your bowl, we're going to clean our workspace. We're gonna take our equipment that was used and dirty to the sink and clean it using soapy water that's warm. So next, we're gonna prepare our riskier ingredients, and that's our eggs, our milk, and our ground beef. With regards to ground beef, we recommend you thaw your ground beef a day in advance overnight, because this is the safest way to bring it out of the freezing phase. You can thaw it in the sink with running water. It's important to keep the water cold when running in the sink, just to make sure that bacteria cannot grow. We're gonna prep our egg, our milk, and lastly, our ground beef. At home, usually just use your hands to mix. If you are wearing watches, rings, jewelry, it is suggested that you remove these so it doesn't trap any bacteria. Now that it's all mixed well, we can transfer it to our loaf pan. I like to use one hand that's already dirty to put it directly into the loaf pan. Before we move on to any next steps, we're gonna wash our hands and we're gonna get rid of this contaminated bowl. Now the meatloaf goes into our preheated oven. All right. It's important to note the internal temperatures to cook ground beef to. It is suggested to cook ground beef to 165 degrees Fahrenheit or 73 degrees Celsius. And that is the same for chicken. All right, and there's our meatloaf. So before we cut into it, make sure it's completely cooked, and that's using our temperature probe here. You want to insert it into the thickest part of the meatloaf, which is often the center, and we're over 165, so we're good to go. So at this point, you're ready to serve it to your family. Now that our meatloaf has been taken out of the oven, we have brought it to room temperature. You can't leave it at this temperature for more than 2 hours because microorganisms tend to rapidly grow between the temperature of 40 to 140 degrees Fahrenheit or 4 degrees Celsius to 60 degrees Celsius. And that's what we call the danger zone. If you have any leftovers from dinner, we want to make sure it is cooled down from the hot temperature that you get it out of the oven. The reason being is if you add hot foods into a refrigerator, you're not only affecting the temperature of the food itself, but the foods that are already stored in the refrigerator. So there's a lot of myths around using plastic versus glass. There really is no difference. It's just important to note that if it's sealing correctly, you're good to store it in the fridge. If you have any further questions, please check out your local health authority's website for more information on food safety. If you're gonna eat, eat safe.